This is a scenario that someone got from the E&M University, and I believe that's an online coding site, and they would like to know why only one bullet was credited for the cardiovascular system. This is the scenario that they were given. And again, normally we don't go in and answer questions from other sites. We like to say, what did you think? And then we'll have, you know, we can maybe explain why you're on track or why you're off track to help build you up, but not, you know, just in case this is somebody's E&M University. Like I said, I'm not familiar with what they are, but in the event that this is a test, then, you know, I don't want to be answering it for you. None of us do. Okay, so let's get to it. So we have vital signs, we have general appearance, and then it goes down doing this portion shows the body system. This isn't a full report, mind you. They've just taken this one section of the report. The lungs are clear to auscultation. I went ahead and highlighted this because I think this is where the question's coming from, and I thought I'd do a little education on the CV means cardiovascular. The RRR stands for regular rate and rhythm. Nobody ever spells any of that stuff out. If you can make it an abbreviation, they will do it. No MRGs, which means murmur, rubs, or gallops. And again, these are sounds and things that the physician would listen to. So this is part of the physical exam, not the review of systems, but the physical exam on the patient. Normal carotid upstroke and amplitude without bruits, which is the sound that they're getting in the arteries. The abdomen, again, most of this stuff is, she was asking specifically about cardio, but abdomen soft, non-tender, no masses or HSM, extremities, no peripheral edema or digital stenosis, which means their fingers aren't swollen and they don't have blue fingernails. Let's see, skin, no rash, lesions, or ulcers. Skin's good. Alert and orientated to person, place, and time, which sometimes they'll say alert and orientated times three, which means person, place, and time. So they went through and said they got a bullet for the vital signs, the appearance, the examination of the neck, the auscultation of the lungs, and again, the bullet for auscultation of the heart. And then one bullet for auscultation of the carotid arteries, examination of the abdomen, and it goes on to all these different things. And their question was, how come I only got one for also, you know, for the cardiovascular when they listed all of these things? Well, you usually only get one in a body system. But here's what I found that I think will help explain how that is done in the E&M. The answer is either going to be in 95 and 97 guidelines, and you can use one or the other when you're doing E&M services. You get to pick. The main difference between them is leveling of the exam component, which is exactly the part that she's asking about. You want to use the one that is most beneficial to your provider. Of course, and you're free to use 95s or 97, whichever works best for your provider. However, if you have a specific payer that wants you to use specific guidelines or one or the other, you have to do what they're going to require to get paid. Simple as that. And that's why you'll hear people that are instructors saying, "I'm telling you this because this is what you need to know because CMS." Says that you have to know it this way, and that's the way it'll be on the exam. However, when you get in the real world, Blue Cross Blue Shield likes it done this way, or Medicare requires that you do it this way. They don't care what CMS says. They want you to do this way. If you want Medicare to pay you, you do it that way. It's no big deal. So the pros and cons of using 95 and 97 guidelines. 95 guidelines are kind of lacking in specialties. So if your doctor is a specialist, then again, you know, 95 may not be as generous to your physician. 97 guidelines are lacking in that it requires a lot of specific documentation elements. And again, if you're a general physician, PCP or something, you know, it may not be in, you know, one or the other will work out best for you. So most carriers require you to work with either the body areas or the organ systems, but not both. So 97 guidelines use bullets, and that's what she was using. She was bulleting each one of those to get points for them. You need one bullet for a problem-focused general multisystem exam, six bullets for an expanded problem-focused exam, and or two bullets in at least six organ systems or body area, or 12 bullets in two or more organ systems or body areas for the detailed exam. And Ryan can tell you that this sounds confusing, but after a while, it just becomes second nature to be able to do these. And you've got a graph, you've got a little table that you go and you can, some people laminate them and they can use a little, one of those dry erase markers and click, 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 and count it off and da-da-da-da-da, and that's the code to use. People who like to do that make very good auditors. Note, physicians should never document just one more bullet to achieve a higher level of service. And these are all written, this is all information that you can get in your guidelines for your book. It's also in the APC textbook that we use. But this part right here, physicians should never document just one more bullet to get a higher service level. And I'm wondering if that isn't what they were trying to show here. That doesn't give me the whole scenario, so again, I'm kind of guessing at what they were wanting to know. Laureen is our expert on E&M leveling, and if you have trouble with E&M, you might want to look into the CEU package that we have for E&M, which is fantastic. Fantastic. And in fact, that's how I got better at doing E&M, was doing Laureen's, and I got better at explaining it to the students that I had at that time at the college. So,
get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.